Good morning students. Today we are going to see the next exercise 4.3. Until last week 4.2 exercise we are completed. Today we are going to see 4.3. In that main things is factorization. In factorization two methods are there. First one method is factor tree and second one method is prime factorization. Okay, first factor tree. One number is given means how to do factor tree method. So first we have to find out which number and all coming factors are 60. Okay, in this method, see, for example, I have taken 415s are 60, you know already. We are going to divide the number. Okay, factorization means you are going to divide the number by giving the factors. Okay, so 415s are 60, you know already. After that, 4 we can divide hereafter also, yes, and 15 also we can divide it one more time. So here 2 2s are 4, here 3 5s are 15. Okay, until it is getting prime numbers we have to do this method. Okay, when the number is over, again we cannot divide it, until that we have to write. For example, now we are ending with 2 2 3 5. Hereafter we cannot divide these numbers by any other numbers. Okay, so the same model again in your book is given. First question, it is 90. Two method they are given in your book. Actually we can write 10 lines are 90. Otherwise in your book page number 77 it is given 45 and 2. Okay, see here 10 lines are 90. So 10 further we can divide into 2 into what will come here? What number will come? 2 5s are 10. Okay, here 9 is divided further here. So what number will come? 3 3s are 9. Okay, so finally we got all the prime numbers. Hereafter we cannot divide. So this is the method of factor tree method. Until getting prime numbers we have to divide. Okay, so by that we can get the factors of the given number. Next, second one is prime factorization method. Prime factorization method means here we have to use division method, the same thing, but okay, here we are going to divide the given number by using prime numbers. By using only prime numbers, you know prime numbers are 2, 3, 5, 7 and 11, 13. These are all the prime numbers you are already learned. Previous exercises we are learned what are all the prime numbers, right? Here when you are given, when you are getting one number to find out the prime factorization, you have to draw this division method. Okay, here when you are starting to divide, first you have to start with the smallest number. Smallest prime number is what? 2. Smallest prime number is 2. So next 3, 5, these are all the prime numbers. First we are starting with 2. Okay, you already know the last exercise we are learned. If the number is ending with the even number, it will be divisible by 2. Divisible. Okay, so now I am going to start with 2. It can divide by 2. So 172, I am dividing by 2. So what will come? 8 2s are 16. 1 is remaining, so it will become 12. 6 2s are 12. So 86 I written. Again we are going to divide it by 2. Yes, so we can divide. 4 2s are 8, 3 2s are 6. 43 same. 43 is a prime number. 43 will not divide by any other number, so 43, it is over. Can you understand? So what are all the prime factors of 172? 2 into 2 into 43. These are all the prime numbers are 172. Next, 13,500. Next, this number also we are going to find out the prime factorization method. Okay, here first we have to, I told you, first we have to start with smallest prime number 2. Okay, When it is not possible, we have to choose for another number. Next number we have to go further. So 2 after 3, 3 after 5, we have to check it one by one number. Now I written 13,500, it will divide by 2. So first number I am writing 2 here, nearby this number. So when I am dividing by 2, it is coming 6 2s are 12, 1 is remaining, 7 2s are 14, 1 is remaining, 5 2s are 10, 0. Next, again I am dividing by 2. See, 3 2s are 6, 3 2s are 6, 1 is remaining, 7 2s are 14, 1 is remaining, so it is become 10, 5 2s are 10. Okay, this method we are already saw in the 5th standard, so I am explaining firstly. Okay, hereafter you look at this number. Now we got 3375, this number after dividing 2, 3375 is there. This number will divide by 2. No, right? Because the number is not ending with even number. So this number is not ending with even number because it will not divide by 2, right? So I am using 3 to divide. So 3 ones are 3, 3 ones are 3, 3 2s are 6, 1 is remaining, 15, 5 3s are 15. So you have to divide one by one like this. Again 3, 3 3s are 9, 2 will join here, so 22, 7 3s are 21, 1 is remaining, it is 15, 5 3s are 15. Again divide by 3, see, 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6, 1 is remaining, 15, so 5 3s are 15. So again 125 we have to divide by 5, okay. 5 2s are 10, 2 is remaining, 5 2s are 25, so here 5 5s are 25, so it is came 5, 5 is the end, because this is also prime number, okay. You have to start the number, the dividing division number, you have to divide, all the divisor you have to write to the left hand side, you have to start with the first number. Always last number will be no divisor, because 5 is the last number, the 5 is not having any divisor. Okay, this is the end. So what are all the prime factors? 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 3, 5 into 5 into 5. You have to write all the numbers this direction, 2 and 2, next to 3 3 3, next 5, next to 5, and next to the 5 5. Okay, like that we have to write the prime factorization. Okay, next, fourth question, what is given in your book? Write the smallest 5 digit number and express it in the form of its prime factor. You know already what is the smallest 5 digit number. So smallest 5 digit number is 10,000, yes? Okay, so smallest 5 digit number 10,000, you know, you have to find out the prime factorization for 10,000 now. Okay, so 10,000 we are going to start. As I told you, you have to start with the smallest prime number 2. So I am starting here. So when I am writing 10,000 here, first you start like this. Write 10,000 and put one line here, here 2, write 2, okay, as I told you, last number will not have any divisor. Okay, when you are dividing by 2, it is 5,000, when I am dividing by 2 again, 2,500, again when you are doing by dividing 2, 1,250. Okay, again I am dividing by 2, 625. Okay, now 625 is came. After 625, can we divide by 2? No, because the number is ending with 5, odd number, it will not divide by 2. So can we divide by 3? 3 means what will come? You can check it. 3 2s are 6. After that 0. 25 will not divide by 3. So we cannot. So again I am taking next prime number 5. If I take 5, we can divide by 5. 1 5s are 5. 1 is remaining. So 2 5s are 10. 2 is remaining 25. So 125. After that, when I am dividing 5, 5, next 2 5s are 10, next 5 5s are 25. So it is coming 25. When I am dividing by 5, 25, it will come 5. 5 multiplied by 5, 25. 5 5s are 25. Okay. So what are all the factors I get? I am writing here 10,000 is equal to 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2. Multiply by 2, 4 times I return 2, yes, after that 5 multiply by 5, 5, 5, 2, 2, 2, 5, 5, 5, 4 times 2 coming, 4 times 5 coming. So these are all the factors of least, smallest 5 digit number, that is 10,000, okay. Finally, the 5th question also. I am the smallest number having 4 different prime factors. Prime factors means, you know, prime numbers are starting with 2, 3, 5, 7 like that. It is asking 4 different factors. Okay. And it is given I am the smallest number. Smallest number means what? It should have the smallest prime factors. Okay. So I am writing smallest 4 prime numbers. What are all the smallest 4 prime numbers? 2, 3, 5, 7. These are all the smallest 4 different prime numbers. Yes? Smallest 2, 3, 5, 7. These are all the prime numbers. Different prime numbers, smallest prime numbers. So, how can we get the smallest number? So, smallest numbers are, we have to multiply these 4 factors. 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 7. So 2 3s are 6, 6 5s are 30, 37s are 210. So this is the answer. In this, what are all the things we learn? Only factorization method. One is factor tree method. Another one is prime factorization method. Okay. So remaining problem you have to do as a homework. Okay. Solve by your own so that it will be easy to understand. Okay. Now today we are going to see highest common factor. I already explained you what is meant by highest common factor. Yes, here we are going to find out the HCF of the given number. Here also two methods we are giving. Two methods. Okay. First method is prime factorization method in HCF. After that division method. Okay. Now I will explain how to do. Okay. Now, first question, it is given, see here, third one, 105 and 140 and 175. This one we have to do by prime factorization method. Prime factorization method means three numbers are given, right? Listen carefully. Three numbers are given, so every number we have to find out the prime factorization separately. Okay, after that we have to write the prime factors of the given numbers. Okay, finally we have to write the HCF. How? See here, 105, I find out the prime factors 3 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 7. By looking only you can understand here, see, for 140, 2, 2, 5, 7. So these are all the prime factors. Okay, so for 175, 5 into 5 into 7, these are all the prime factor numbers. Okay, so HCF of 105, 140, 175 are, see here, after writing all the prime factors of the given number, so you have to see what are all the common numbers in that. Already HCF means I told you common, highest common factor. So here first you have to see the common numbers. 3 if you are taking means in both of the numbers 3 is not there. 2 if you are taking means it is not having in the both of these numbers. So common numbers are 5 is a common first, so I have written 5. Next, 7 is also common in 3 of the given number. So 5 multiplied by 7, what are all the numbers is common in the given numbers? Here 3 number given, so 3 of these number, 5 and 7 is common, so 5 sevens are 35. So 35 is the highest common factor of 105, 140 and 175. Can you understand? Very easy method. Next one is division method. In this division method, we no need to find out the prime factorization. Directly by division, we can find out the HCF. Okay. But here only two numbers we can do. Okay. First, I have taken two numbers for your example. Again, three numbers also taken. So one time we can find out for two numbers. Here, see here, two number given. So first you have to take bigger number in the dividend place, smaller number in the divisor place. Okay, here 429 is bigger, so I have written here inside. 198 is the divisor, small number, because of that I taken this. So after that you try it, how much time 199 will come here? I am trying two times. Two times means here 396 is coming, so I have written 396. Remainder is 33. Okay, this is normal division, you know already. But here, if the remainder is coming, we cannot stop it. So remainder is coming means again this divisor you have to write in the divider place. Only one thing you have to very careful. When you are dividing the first number, remainder is coming means the previous divisor you have to write inside. Can you understand? So the divisor is 198, I have written inside. So this remainder is there now here. This is, we have to take it as a divisor. Can you understand? So I have written like this. It is like chain. Okay. Now 198 is a dividend. This is 33 is a divisor. Okay. So we can let us multiply. Simply we are thinking means 33, 6 3s are 18. So by that I am trying 80. Sorry, 6. 33 multiplied by 6, 198. Exactly it is coming. So 6, 33s are 198. The remainder is 0. Okay sir, remainder is coming 0 means how will you write the HCF? So see here, HCF of 198 and 429 is 33. How? When you are dividing the final divisor will be the HCF answer. Okay, so here we done two times division. Final divisor is 33, last divisor, so I have written HCF 33. Okay, next by three number we are going to see the same method. I told you when you are doing division method, one time we can take for two numbers, only one time we can find out for two numbers. So how can we find out the three numbers? Simple. So what can we do? First we can find out the HCF for first two numbers. So I have taken first two number, 120 and 144, bigger number dividend, smaller number divisor. Okay, so divide it. In 144 only one time 120 is coming, 120, remainder is 24. So what we need to do? Again this divisor, take it into divided. So 120 I written. How much 24 will come? Yes, and I am checking 5 times. 5 24 are 120. So I have written 5 here, 120, remainder is 0. We will not take the quotient for anything, leave it. But the last divisor 24. So the 24 is the HCF of 120 and 144. Okay, for first two number we are find out this is the HCF 24. Next, again what we need to do now? What HCF you are find out? 24. With the answer you have to find out for the third number. Can you understand? First two number we are doing and finding out the HCF. After that, by this HCF and the third number we are going to find out the HCF. Okay, so now bigger number 204 dividend, smaller number divisor, Now find out the HCF again. So see here, 24 8s are 192. So 8 times 24, 192. Remainder is 12. Remainder is 12. After that, 12 is the remainder. So this divisor will be come in divide and 24. 2 12s are 24. Remainder 0. So last divisor is 12. Last divisor is 12. So HCF are 24 and 204 is 12. Okay. So finally, what answer you got final? That is the HCF of 120, 144, 204. Okay. Once again, I will repeat. First two number you find out the HCF and find out the value of 24. Next, by this value you can find out the HCF of third number and this answer. Final one answer you will get. This is the answer for three number. This is the HCF of three number. Okay. Compared to this step, it will come easily, but you have to understand simply. Okay. So the HCF is this 12. Next, fourth question. Find the greatest number which can divide 257 and 329 as to leave a remainder 5 in each case. Two numbers are given, 257 and 329. Okay. That number is what? Which will be divided by one number. That greatest number we don't know. Okay. Both number given, that is 257, 329. It is having remainder 5. Okay. I am writing remainder 5 in each. Two number given. When we are dividing by the number, the number is not given, we are going to find out. By dividing that number, we will get the remainder 5. Okay, so I am writing. So exactly divisible by the largest number. When you are dividing the largest number, they are telling remainder is coming 5 in each number. So without remember is coming means it is exactly divisible. So exactly divisible means what will come? From the given number, we have to subtract 5 in both. So 257 minus 5, 252, 329 minus 5, 324. These both number will be divided by the particular number. Okay. Now, we are going to find out the number. First, what we have to do? Same thing. Here given greatest number, no? Greatest number which is divisible by. So I know, I already told you, greatest number means we can take an highest common factor. Okay, highest common factor. So here also HCF only. So bigger number 329, 324, smaller number 252. So we can do the division method. Okay, one time 72 is the remaining. Write again 252 inside. Yes, so I am trying 72 three times, 216 is coming. Again remainder is coming, so I am writing 36. So what we'll do, 36 remainder is came, this divisor I am writing again here. Don't take this one, previous only. So this remainder I written, so this 72 I written here. So 236 are 72, remainder 0. So required largest number is 36. Can you understand, student? So the required largest number is actually the HCF of the both number. Okay. So only we are subtracted the remainder and we are written the number. So we are find out the HCF. So answer is 36. Next, word problem, seventh problem. See, for finding out the HCF, if you are seeing the word problem commonly, they will ask find the largest number, find the maximum capacity, or find the maximum value of the number, like that they are given. After that, they are asking the common thing is, see, in first sixth question and seventh question, exact number of time, exact number of time. So what it is denoting, when they are asking greatest and highest number, we are telling na highest common, highest, okay, HCF, highest. And when they are asking exact number of times, means common. So when you are seeing in the word problems, I am telling you this is very simple to identify. When they are asking greatest number, great maximum number, and exact number of the times, exact number of the time means it is they are asking highest common factor. Okay, so here also I taken for you seventh question. I have choose to do seventh question. In that they are asking three tankers are there. They are containing 403 and 434, 465 liters of diesel. Okay, they are asking maximum capacity, which is the exact number of time. See, which, how much liter commonly it will come in the three of the value they are asking. Okay, so in these three value, which number will be the common number of the value. So they are asking that only. So HCF, first, as usual, we are going to do first two number. So I have done 434, 403 one time, 31 is the remainder. Okay, next, if you are doing 13 times, it is coming, okay, dividing without any remainder. Okay, so HCF of 403, 434 is 31. Next, again find out the HCF for 31 and 465. So next, by division you have to find out this. So 31, remainder 15. So 5 times 31 is 155. So HCF of 31 and 460 is 31. So the required capacity of the container also 31 liter. Understand, this is the HCF only, but when they are asking in the word problem, they will ask maximum value or more, maximum capacity or anything, or greater value, and which is the common exact number of times. Exact number of time means how much exactly, with how much value we can divide the numbers. Okay, that is the common number they are asking. Okay, so we are finding out the HCF of the given number. This is a 31 for this answer. Okay, so exercise 4.4 also we are completed. So next class we will start 4.5, that is the least common factor, LCM. Okay, until now we are completed the prime factorization and HCF also, prime factorization method and division method we are learn. Okay, I hope you are understand. If you are not understand also, you can play again and you can see the video again. Okay, I will send this notes copy as a photo in your WhatsApp group. Okay, so that it will be easy to copy also. Okay, thank you. And one more thing, you have to do homework in 4.4, what are all the problems I done, you know, remaining problems you have to do as a homework. Okay, especially fifth question in the exercise 4.4, this is same method of fourth question which I done. Okay, and you can take the model of exercise example 3, page number 80. Example 3 is there, the same model, fifth question. So do as a homework. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day.